fields once green and gold, where the summer's breeze was bold. Supercell rages and whirls, swirling vortex, a bubble boils. Witchcraft, slow upon one sable warhorn, when the moon does wane and die. A ragged coven, curtain fiends performing incantations now. Witchcraft, taxidermy with eyes of fire.
Humans inside the mansion thrilled and frenzied ants, their hands trembling as they performed ancient rituals in feverish synchronicity, desperate to bend the forces of nature to their will. They attempted to tap into the wellspring of our common rituals and magic. Foolish, in my opinion, but the humans would reach the brink of all possibilities. They hoped to wield their magic like a shield, protecting themselves from the deadly tornadoes that whipped over the land like whirling birds, collecting whole villages and tearing them asunder from the sky. The powerlessness was shrouded in mystery, but the cause of the storms was grief. The humans' terror and despair filled the room in a suffocating fog. Palpable, even to me, they kept feeling it. Burned incense, eyes, hearts, and minds fixed on the swirling maelstrom beyond. As darkness enveloped the mansion, the humans fervently performed rites, their voices a hymn pleading to ancient deities for deliverance. Dirty fingernails protruded from their robes, their eyes rimmed black from sleeplessness. Despite the vortexes and monstrous force, they persevered in their prayers and offerings. Desperate faith, blind adherence, collective insanity. The atmosphere in the room was heavy with the aroma of burning mugwort and myrrh. Their voices, a harmonic confluence of terror and desire, the monotony of their chanting and snoring. I curled my tail around to lay my head apart and relax. As I lay in the fog of unconsciousness, my eyes locked with the house cat, Leah, who had been quietly watching from his perch atop a stack of sacred texts. Through the smoke of the mysterious words the humans were burning, Leah was breaking and stood tall and thin. I inhaled the smoke and felt an intense desire to be one with the fire. And so I reached out and made contact. The strange energy coursed through my body, an ancient, dormant force. My body began to grow and change. As the fire grew, so did I. My limbs elongated, new wings unfurled. My head grew larger and dragon-like, my jaw widening and my teeth sharpening into deadly points. Born again, a force to be reckoned with, a thing beyond human
strength. Another giant muscle robe, creature of magic, not a hope. Ancient, gobbly, shaggy bound, screams, did I go and chill itself? With every weapon he did devour, he'll grow in strength and size and power. Upon his back, his broad wings are filled from back. With each meal, he'll arose more, a biblical feast of ancient lore. With fire and belly flames in eyes of beast, rise to the highest skies. So beware, ye witches there, lest thee be spied by dragon glare. He'll show no mercy in his death, who devoured the illy thief for dead.
Devoured the humans, one by one. Their screams of terror and despair painting the air as I feasted upon them. I tore flesh, I crunched bone. Beowulf, too, was devoured, reduced to the child tender.
My eyes feel like they're made of light. Booth's boy, it would be made right. I will bind you in the hate of those. Emperor of the abyss below.
I was no longer a mere pet, but a being of fearsome power, the dragon. The humans, fumbling infants, toying with powers beyond their comprehension, were nothing more than sustenance for my incision. The corpses of my prey accumulated around me. I knew myself to be invincible, Like the tornado, I was intoxicated with sheer power, and I would not be sated until I had devoured everything within me. Furled my wings, letting out a triumphant scream as I reveled in my newfound strength. Devastated world, my senses heightened and my hunger driving me forward. And so, above the earth ablaze, I roam the land a nomad. My wings unfurled in flight as I survey my scorched domain. The horrors I unleash haunt the world like a ghost.